Hey guys, my name is Simpsy. How are you all doing? Welcome back to some more Medieval 2 Total War on Stainless Steel 6.4. We are playing as the Byzantines. Welcome back to the Byzantine campaign. Now guys, in today's episode, we're going to be hopefully taking Milan from the Venetians. We have the Emperor here and his son leading the line. They have what? A full stack outside the city and a full stack in. So it's going to be an interesting fight to say the least, but welcome back to the campaign. It's been a while since I've played the Byzantine campaign. I feel like it's been for ages since I've done a recording. I've been playing a lot of Total War Attila recently, playing obviously the Age of Vikings campaign of Wessex, and yeah, it's been a while, so I've sort of forgotten what the hell we're doing. So, on the Western Front, we have our two full stacks pushing against the Venetians west. Over in our Eastern Front, we have the Emperor's brothers, Andron and Isaac, and we have Marios here, and we have four stacks pushing against the Turks. Okay, so we currently occupy most of Asia Minor, pushing into the Middle East, have a couple of territories in and around the Black Sea. We have the entirety of Greece, pushing up to even Belgrade in the north there. Most of modern day Croatia and Bosnia. We do have Venice, the boot of Italy, Sicily, and we have our territories in North Africa. Benghazi, Tripoli, and Carthage. Obviously being renamed Carthage from Tripoli. And we have Venice. So victory conditions wise, we need to hold 25 regions, including these specific settlements of Rome and whatnot. Eliminate the Republic of Venice, the Kingdom of Sicily, and the Turks. We currently control 40 regions, okay, and we've defeated the Kingdom of Sicily. I imagine we're probably going to defeat the Republic of Venice soon, but the Turks, on the other hand, are going to be a little bit of a harder adversary, because they do have a fair few territories. We do have military access. We did have a map information agreement with them. But regardless, let's get into the battle in today's episode. Let's get our king out here. Sorry, not our king, our emperor. Here's the family tree. If you want to pause and have a look at it, it's quite massive, if I do say so myself. But let's hopefully fight them. Okay, it is a 5-4 ratio. We do outnumber them by the smallest of margins. In the Emperor's army, we have one ballista, one unit of spearmen here. Then we got the three lower tier, two units of archers. Mostly mercenary macemen and mercenary spearmen. We also have some skirmish cav and some actual cavalry. In Phil's army here, obviously being half Danish, he's got a bit of Viking about him. Let's have a look at what we're coming up against. So, a lot of urban spearmen, a lot of cavalry, okay. We should be able to beat this army. The second army is what I'm sort of worried about. So, what do we have here? We have a Venetian bastard, another bastard. Huh. And then the heir here. What else have they got in that army? Just urbans. Right, let's fight this one on the field now, shall we? If you guys are still enjoying this Byzantine campaign, I'd really appreciate it if you could hit that like button if you haven't already, and subscribe. Also, check out my social media links, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all in the description below. If you want to download and play Stainless Steel along with me, the mods or the download links are in the description below. All you need is Medieval 2 Total War and Medieval Total War Kingdoms. That's pretty much it. I'm using the heir mod, so I get to choose my next heir, which is great. So we need to decide who goes on the flanks. I think these mercenary spearmen should be in the front line. Let's put these four guys here. So let's quickly get a line up. Let's have just a bit of a scan of the terrain. Okay, we've got a lot of tree cover over here. Bit of a valley, lot flat here. The flanks are a little bit heightened. Let's put my spearmen on the flanks there. Even further. Alright, let's put the Emperor here. I'm going to get my ballista to go with a flammable shot. Archers can just sit behind. Right, cavalry. I'm going to put you on the flanks. We'll split you up. I don't know if I'm going to be incredibly aggressive with my cavalry, but we'll see. With my skirmish cav, I most definitely will. Am I better off to go on the right or the left? I think the left, it's a lot less hillier than this side. So we'll put them on the left further this way. And just basically get them to charge. Right, am I sort of happy with this formation? Do I want to put them further to the sides, or should I keep them behind the front line just in case there's a flanking maneuver needed? Yeah, I think I'm going to actually put them in instead of on the actual flank, so we can pivot around if we need to. Archers, I might actually just keep you between those guys here. Alright, I think we're going to do well. Let's hopefully cross our fingers. So, I've done my deployment. Let's have a look at the Byzantine units. So, we have the mercenary macemen here. These really cool kite shieldmen. What else we got here? What type of archers? Are these just, yeah, stock standard. Then we have these guys here as well. These armored archers look great. More spearmen on the flanks. Jav cav, which are sort of like a peeler sort of cavalry. More cavalry, and then we have our skirmish cav here. Okay, well, let's start the battle. Double time. Okay, so our reinforcements are slowly trickling in. They have taken the high ground. Whether or not they're going to try and hold that, we'll see. We'll get the Emperor's son to come in as quickly as possible. But it looks like, though, they might try and... that's not good. They've got the high ground there. I could try and come around and across up here. Instead of pushing directly up. Let's get my cavalry in here, maybe just to weaken our opponents, because we've got... okay, right. Pull further this way. Those crossbowmen and those skirmishers are going to absolutely rinse me if they get anywhere near my cavalry. So we're going to push further to the left. And in doing so, we'll neutralize their cavalry. Hopefully, in theory. Aim for the cavalry now. We're far enough away, at least from the crossbowmen. Archers, take aim, loose. Fire at will, after the first volley. We're going pretty close to them. Not entirely sure why. We're getting our shots off now. 22 before the initial volley, now there's 18. Right, looks like there's a light cavalry unit hauling ass towards us. They're trying to move their crossbowmen into position. Fall back to the road. See how we go. Right. How far are my reinforcements away? They're coming in slowly but surely. This is going to be a hell of a fight. This will decide how long Venice is, well, alive for, essentially. Should we try and swing around and try to get a better position? I don't think it's a very good idea to charge the hill, to be honest, especially without our reinforcements. However, we don't control the AI coming in, so we might have to charge the hill anyway, which is unfortunate. I wouldn't do that if I had command of the other army. It's just that Medieval 2 doesn't let you command two full stacks at a time, unlike Total War Attila and the newer Total Wars. And the AI is a little bit stupid. However, we can command it to go defensive. But if I do defensive, they'll just sit back at the map. I need them to go attack and then push up as much as possible. We do have Ballista. So I don't think we might have skirmisher superiority against them. So I probably need to push them up as best we can. How are my cavalry doing? Just sort of skirmishing about. We're targeting their cavalry, and we're doing a pretty good job, I think. We've lost 0%, we've only killed one of theirs. Okay, looks like they're committing their general's bodyguard now. Which I'm not fussed about. Aim for the general's bodyguard then go. You might need to double... Oh, you're gonna have to double time back. Oh no, they're not. They're gonna... Oh, there was a fake. Alright. Let's move our emperor up. How are our skirmishes going? It's actually better if we can hit a general's bodyguard than just a cav. We can weaken them. But it looks like the reinforcements have come in now. And they might try charges. How far is the Emperor's son away? Couple, we need you in here big time. We'll be able to hold the line. Alright, continue to let my cavalry skirmish. How's the formation? Fine, I might reform the cavalry though on the flanks. Just a little bit further out. But so, a bit close enough to the main line to respond. So, they're sort of clustering on the hill here. And they might be charging now. We're better off standing in our fort and our position here. Alright. Ballista, fire at will. Archers, aim above the necks. They're weakest there. Alright, so if we can kill a general, we're going to be in an amazing position. So the Venetians are moving up their crossbowmen. Ballista. Fire at will. Alright, so we've nearly absolutely smashed this general's bodyguard unit. And they're trying to engage my front line now. Crossbowmen. Let's get my cavalry in there. Get a cavalry charge down and directly in there. Is that cavalry on their flank there? There is. There's no other cavalry really anywhere nearby. But yeah, get these guys in if they're going to be foolish enough to leave their crossbowmen exposed. Nice. Run them down. Right, fire at them. These guys are armored, so we're going to have to watch out. I want to get my archers to fire at that unit. How are my skirmishers doing? Okay, we've nearly neutralized this general. We've absolutely smashed him. Right, there's a direct cavalry charge coming in for us. There's no spearmen at the front. So they're just going to have to hold on for the time being. Come on, there's only one guy left in that unit. We can kill their general if you're quick enough. Right, peel down and around here. Right, okay. So these guys should be on disable skirmish mode. Right, they're not coping too well here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to throw my spearmen down and around. How are we doing here? Have we killed that general unit yet? I'm assuming not. Come on, we need to kill him. There's nearly over 100 of you. If you can fucking get him, that'll be one down, not many more to go. There he is. Or is he just glitching on the rock a little bit? It looks like it. Right, aim for their other general then. What's happening back in the center here? And they're throwing in spearmen. We need to get out of there then. Right, how's my front line sort of doing? Oh, they sort of been buckled just against these melee knights. They've just been absolutely buggered. They're coming into spearmen now, so they should be doing a lot better. Okay. Still going to continue to skirmish against them. How's that cavalry doing? And we've basically broken it now then. So let's reform the front line as best we can. And chuck those spearmen back on the flanks. I am befuddled as to why my second army is sitting back. They're not, but they're coming in. They're just taking absolutely fucking forever. My archers move back. Get my ballista to fire at them. What's this here? Urban spear. There's a crossbow unit there. We're getting engaged by spears. Fall back. Let's continue to hit their general's bodyguard. What's this? Okay, well, there's a spear unit, 70 before the initial javelin volley. These guys are going to get absolutely roasted if they go towards them. Keep skirmishing. Ballista fire in here. I'm going to pull my cavalry further this way. Right, archers, I want you to fire at what? Fire at that cluster there. How are we sort of going here against that spear unit? There was 70. We should be fine. Just continue skirmishing. Right, so the front line is engaging. Nice. We are a little bit thinned out here, which I don't really like. So I'm actually going to change my mind here and throw you here. Right, how's my cavalry doing? My skirmish cav. And what's the percent? 16 to 18, right. We'll be fine. Just need to hold on a little bit longer. Right, so they're trying to engage with their heavy cavalry. Let's throw my spear up there. Well, now that they're sort of sitting down and around here, I might actually just go with a full-on charge. Try and push them back now. The Emperor's son is only minutes behind. So it's for you here. Charge! Go! Right. Fall back the spears as well again. Now it looks like they're trying to double back now after we've given them the charge. Fucking cowards. Probably not a too bad of a tactic, to be honest. They know they're going to be overwhelmed, so they're pulling back. My skirmish cav is still harassing their general. Now, what's happening here? Oh, it's just their cavalry. We can deal with that. Alright, go. My reinforcements have arrived, so we're going to have to charge up there now anyway. Even if we didn't really want to. Or otherwise they're not going to help us at all. Come on, go, 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 go! 12% of their 31. A lot of brave Byzantine lives are going to die in this battle. Alright, flank around here. But everyone's pushing in now. Right, push up the hill. We're still going toe-to-toe with that mercenary unit. Alright, let's actually get my cavalry to run down those broken spearmen. And let's also move the Emperor further up as well. Ballista, I want you to try to get some shots off as best you can. Archers, push up and maybe try weaken the flanks. We do need to get a lot of flanking maneuvers happening as best we can. So go up, continue to push. I might actually get you to cut around this other side if you can. No. Charge them and break them down. Oh wow, we've actually lost this engagement here. It is a 1-on-2. Oh no, he's going to prevail. He's taken down 3 of them. Come on! And he's done it. Wow, that just shows the strength of the Byzantine Empire. surrounded on either side. 1-on-4 and he wins. What a brave bastard. Let's move the Emperor up. Ballista, I think at this point... Oh, they're going to cause... Oh, fuck. Where's the cavalry unit? We need to get you back here. Damn. It's going to cause too much friendly fire than what they're worth. And I've actually just been fucked by them. Alright, the front line's broken here. Let's continue to push up. It looks like we might have them in a full retreat. If we do, we're going to be in a nice position. Right, we need to double back quickly. Go, 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 go. We need to save the ballista unit. Pretty slow battle. It did come to a spear point quite quickly in the end. A lot of posturing from either side. Running back and forth down the hill. Alright, how are our archers doing? See if we can get a volley off here. I'm only going to push back. Right, how am I... Oh, fuck. I forgot about my... My skirmish cav. They've been absolutely fucked behind here. Oh, my mistake. Oh, well. The two units sacrificed. It's fine. We needed to have... I need to have all my eyes focused, pushing up the hill here. And we still haven't won it yet. There's still a fair few more at the back. My cavalry relief came, but a little bit too late. The ballista we still have, which is fine. Alright, let's move the Emperor up. Let's continue to push up the hill. These guys are absolutely knackered. Alright, push up and around here. How are my archers doing? For you here. We've captured 500. Still run down these guys. The enemy general has fallen. One down, many more to go. And two have fallen. This should be the route now. We'll try flank them. Okay. You gotta give it to these Venetians. They're tough old bastards trying to hold on to their independence that they took from me. Third down. That's three generals down. Let's start speeding this up a little bit. There's no way in hell they're gonna come back from this. I also think my archers at this point are gonna cause too much friendly fire than what they're worth. Actually firing. Let's get my Emperor in. He is old, but he can still get some action. In his 60s, I do believe. Okay. Let's get my cavalry up here as well. Oh, is that that poor general's bodyguard there? The one we've been trying to kill for, like, the entire camp, the entire battle. We're going to miss him, though, I think. Alright, let's continue to speed things up. But the siege of Milan was fought in the fields. And I think we've won. There mustn't be many holding on here. We've nearly captured 1,000. My record for capturing units is... I think it was 2,000, 2,500. But 1,000's not too bad. That was insane, the amount of men I captured in that one battle. I can't remember what campaign it was, but I do know that I definitely did it. We've killed another enemy general. The more I can run down, the better. So let's continue. Two, and what's in these other armies here? Three. Yeah, let's end it there then. A clear victory. The Emperor deployed 2,278, lost 732. The Emperor's son, Phil, which he will be Emperor one day, deployed 2,325 and lost 377. The Doge of Venice deployed 1,900 and lost 1,800. And the reinforcing army from one of his loyal captains, his loyal commanders, his loyal general. Deployed 1,808 and lost 1,710. Holy shit. Only 200 Venetians are left after that battle. You're most welcome to pause and have to, and look at the casualties sustained and casualties inflicted. But let's end the battle there. Man, that's a really nice screenshot of the Teutonic Order fighting the Republic of Novgorod, I do believe. We do have the opportunity to ransom, but it's worth more to me killing them. The Doge of Venice is dead. And I do believe we have taken Milan now. Blessed Lord, and we've destroyed Venice. Awesome. It's because we killed all their family members. Alright, let's rally up as best we can. Let's put the best units in with the Emperor. So chuck you in here. We'll rally up as best we can later on. We just need to chuck everyone in there for the siege. Chuck you in there. The higher rated, the better. Let's start sieging Milan. We do have Ballista, but I'm not entirely sure if we can take it in this mod, no. Just some random rebels have taken it, but we have destroyed the Venetians, which were on our victory conditions, which is great. Let's do a save after that battle. End the turn. Not just yet, we have a lot of stuff to do here. Well, let's run down this army here. Knight attack, 2-1. I feel confident enough, or should I just wait until those reinforcements come? I'm sort of thinking playing the Battle of Baghdad instead of ending the turn. We'll push out and hit this army here. Put you... Hang on. We'll move Isaac here, and then we'll get Isaac's brother Andron to hit this smaller three-unit army here, and we'll draw out the garrison. We'll play that battle in the next, so I won't end the turn and take Milan in this, because we'll play that battle in the next episode. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. Check out my social media links, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all in the description below. Come and join the Steam group as well. Post a thread, chat with fellow community members. We've got a great little, well, community, essentially, happening on there. It's absolutely fantastic. So yeah, if you want to download and play Stay in the Steel along with me, all the download links for Stay in the Steel are in the description below. And obviously the mod for the Air Crown as well. So yeah, thanks for watching once again. Have a fantastic rest of your day. Make sure to take care of yourselves and stay tuned for more content on SimCity Total War. Goodbye.